You look troubled.
I'm hurting.
Hi, Andy.
Hi. I know why you're all looking at me. It's my hair, isn't it?
No. We usually look at people who are talking. It's considered polite.
Having a bad hair day, huh, Andy?
Shut up. That's not very sensitive.
Whoopsie.
Anyways, Andy, we've realized that hair is just who we are. Tell us what happened.
This morning, my hair dryer broke, and I had to, like, air dry my hair. Raw, unheated air was touching my hair.
You poor girl.
Look at me. I tried everything. Spray gel, mousse, detangler, conditioner, curling lotion, straightening tonic, and antifrizz foam, but nothing helped.
Did you try sculpting spray?
No, sculpting sprays, of course. Thanks, Haley.
Sabine, you look troubled. Want to talk about it?
Yes, I'm hurting. So's Alex. I've been trying to get it open up, but she won't.
I think it's time for a little bit of group support.
Poet
loving a pirate.
What did you mean, of a dating service?
No, I met a mommy and my parents for vacationing in the Caribbean.
Please share your phone with us,
Anna. Okay. The parrot, the beard, the black eye patch. Me and my baggy jeans were a perfect match. When I look into your eye, as blue as the sky, I know I'm married to you, and you are my mate. Who would have thought that a pantaloon would make me gush and make me sweat?
It's so romantic.
I know, but my parents are so totally against this. They want to know where's the security in being married to a pirate. Life can mean security when you've got a pirate.
Yeah! We are so sorry.
Thank you for bringing me to share that.
You haven't shared with us yet.
Well, I really don't have any problems. I'm really happy, and my life is great.
She's repressing. I've seen this a million times before.
You know, I'm really happy. In fact, I think I came to the wrong club. This isn't the Optimist Club, is it?
Nope. This is teens.
Healthy teens!
Oh. Well, then it better go. Bye, everyone. It was really nice to meet you all.
Traitor?
Loser. What a weirdo. Mm-hmm.
All right, well, that's all the time we have for today. We'll see you all next week.
Group high!
Yay!
Oh no, this can't be happening.
I don't believe it.
You're wearing my dress.
No, you're wearing my dress.
The sales lady told me no one else from North High bought this dress.
She told me the same thing. I will never trust the sales lady again.
What are we going to do?
I don't know.
Ooh, I don't suppose you'd leave?
Leave the high school prom? I have been waiting for this my whole life.
So have I. I've been saving up my babysitting money all year to buy the coolest dress in the store.
Hey, I know. Why don't we tear yours?
What?
You know, make it shorter, tear the sleeves off. It would look totally different then.
Are you crazy? Do you know how much this dress costs?
Yes, I know exactly how much it costs. Probably the same as mine.
I just hope my date Drew doesn't see us wearing the same dress. What a way to end my high school career.
What a way to... Drew, who?
This is my
dress! He asked me!
He has to keep running
here! He's my boyfriend!
WWGSD? What would Gwen Stefani do? She's my hero.
I love her. What do you think she would do?
I think she'd just stay at the prom and have a great time anyway.
You mean like rise above it?
Yeah. I mean like what choice do we really have here?
You know, if we could rise above this obstacle, it might make us stronger people. Like when they say suffering builds character.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Let's go.
Like we did on purpose.
I'm so sorry.
No worries.
Do you know where room 30? first day.
Mine too.
Hurry, hurry, hurry. Home.
We are the guidance counseling units.
We are here to guide. Ask questions. We will answer.
We were looking for room 34A.
And we're late.
They're lost.
Wonderful. We're here to help the lost and confused.
We're looking for room 34A.
I think the teacher's name is Mr. Ravinger.
Your name?
Oh, I am.
Your name?
I'm Al.
Age?
15.
14?
Gender?
Female.
The male unit is confused.
Lucky for him, we came. Of course, it's confused. Look at them. Every teenager is confused. It's like the blunt leading the blunt.
Hey, that's not very nice.
Hey, don't argue with him. We're really late. We should go.
Do not go. We are here to help you.
Give directions and guidance. Answer any and all questions.
We need to know where room 34A is.
Sit
down, him, her.
There's no place to sit. We're in the hallway.
The female unit is speaking.
How do you learn if you don't listen?
They think they know everything.
Detention!
Sorry. Hey, that's kind of rude.
What are you going to do with the rest of your life?
What do you want to be? Where are you going to go?
Have you paid for college?
Have you paid for a major? Have you decided how to handle the multiple demands of career, motherhood, and wifedom?
I don't know. I'm only 14.
She doesn't know.
Do you think you have your whole life ahead of you?
Go for it. Just do it.
Go for what? Do what? What are you talking about?
When things get tough, the tough get going.
There's only one numero uno.
I don't know what I want to do. I'm only 15. I don't need this kind of pressure.
It's a dog eat dog world.
Watch out for number one. You can pick your friends. You can pick your nose. But you can't wipe your friends under the couch.
Good one, Unit 3.
High hats.
High hats.
As you see, we are hip, cool, and use your lingo. We are awesome. We rule. We are radial.
Perhaps you mean radical.
Yes, we are radical. High hats.
High five, not high heads.
Game three.
Game three?
Look at them. They are stupefied. They want their MTTV.
MTTV?
They want their MTTV.
It's MTV, not MTTV.
All my fellow guidance counseling units.
What unit one?
We have an appointment with the liberal arts major, Morgan Mullen, and we're almost late with an appointment with him.
Liberal arts? Another future fast food person.
Maybe we're not too late to change his or his mind. Let's go.
Goodbye, Denver.
We still need to know where 34A is.
Just let them go. We'll find it out ourselves.
Yeah, you're right. We're better off figuring things out for ourselves. Up in the morning and up.
The people at the rest home love them. My volunteer coordinator says they're great because they promote regularity. Hey, we could advertise them that way.
No, you do not talk about regularity at a bake sale.
Hey, I worked for hours on these.
They're all hard as rock.
Yeah.
You could lose a tooth sampling one.
My bad. I fell asleep while they were in the oven.
How could you fall asleep?
I was so exhausted. Why didn't you bake something?
My job was to coordinate the tables of the bake sale. I literally had paperwork coming out of my ears. I had play practice, and then I had to babysit. I'm exhausted.
We're doing this for charity, which is a good thing. So why are we screaming at each other?
Okay, you're right. But this bake sale was my responsibility, and now it's not going to make a penny for the children's hospital.
I'm sorry.
No. I never should have asked you to bake them at the last minute.
No, it's my fault. I should have told you that I didn't have time.
Wait, I have an idea. What if we have a bet you can't eat one buffet? We charge everyone $1 to try to eat one, and if we can, we give them $2 back.
That sounds like a good idea, but are they really that bad?
Yeah, they're really that bad.
Well then, let's do it. You stay here and guard the table, and I'll go get some posters.
Let's make a sign that says no liability for broken teeth.
Good point. Aren't you going to stay and guard the table?
No, I don't think there's any danger there.
True. And if someone does try to steal them?
They get what they deserve.
You can count on me.
Hi, I'm Rick. How you guys doing?
Good.
Yeah, I see y'all. Yeah, down there in that corner. All right, so I'm gonna tell you a quick story about this desk right here. It's not that great of a desk. So it all started after class. Something so awful, horrifying, and embarrassing, no one ever really talks about it. The perpetrator? The school desk. You know the one I'm talking about. The one with the tiny chair and a bearably low table attached. I mean, we are expected to face 12 years, 8 hours a day, thousands and thousands of hours, sitting in that school desk. I'm like 5'6", or something like that. My knees have been bruised since the third grade. But bruises, scrapes, wet gouts of gum, even death threats carved there by the delinquents you share the desk with. All of that is nothing compared to the devious, evil spirit of the school desk. At any moment, while trapped in that school desk, can cause the unfortunate chair noise. Pretend you don't know what I'm talking about. It's all happened. It pierces the boredom of the classroom like a shot. Everyone looks at you horrified, and you start to whisper, "It was a chair. It was a chair." But then, you try and move again and again. There's no sound. There isn't. By now, whispers and laughters start to surround you, and you find yourself screaming, "It was the chair! It was the chair!" But you can rub your bottom raw before that chair ever makes a noise again. It's true. This kind of thing never happens to cheerleaders or jocks. And when you're dealing with the infinite mercy of your peers, you're never going to be able to live it down. Now I'm going to have to become like Dwayne Johnson or win a Nobel Prize just to get through the reunions. Like I don't have enough pressure as being a teenager. Thank you.
Today's fairy tale is called Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Once upon a time.
Oopsies.
What?
Who would like to tell Uncle Buster what's the matter? Kira.
Okay. Yes. Yes. So, as I was saying, Snow White and...
Oh, no.
What?
Kira?
Why, Uncle Buster, must it be color specific?
Is Snowflesh you okay?
Acceptable.
What? So, Snowflesh you'd lived with the seven dwarfs. The seven vertically challenged males deep in the woods. Their names were Grumpy.
Oh no!
Grumpy, shouldn't you say emotionally disadvantaged?
Sure!
Thank you, Grace.
Their names were Dopey.
Oh no!
It's way easier. And they're all sleepy.
Narcoleptic, Uncle Buster!
Narcoleptic? Okay. Then there was Happy. There's seriously something wrong with the name Happy. You have to go to the bathroom as well. You can go.
You're making a value judgment, Uncle Buster. Psychically centered.
Psychically centered, of course. Then there was Sneezy.
Oh, sinus sensitive, Uncle Buster. I have the same problem. And believe me, it hurts when someone makes light of it.
Oh, forgive me. Uncle Buster did not mean to offend. Forgive me. And then there was Bashful.
Socially dyslexic, Uncle Buster.
Socially dyslexic. Alright, so, Snowflesh Hugh lived with emotionally disadvantaged, intellectually deprived, psychically centered, sinus sensitive, socially dyslexic, and Doc, whom we shall refer to as Watercraft Accessible. lived in the woods. And one day, a wicked queen...
Haven't you guys ever noticed it's always the queen that's here?
Yeah!
So, a royal person of indeterminate gender gave a poisoned apple to Snowflesh Hugh.
Chemicals and pesticides, insecticides and sprays!
Okay. So, a chemically coated apple poisoned with man's attempts to control nature was given to Snowflesh Hugh by a royal person of indeterminate gender. This apple caused Snowflesh Hugh to fall into a deep coma. The vertically challenged males, thinking she was dead, put her into a glass coffin. And one day, a prince rode by and kissed her.
Living will
that it was perfectly all right for a prince to ride by and mutual agreement for dividing all housework equally ever after. The end.
Thank you, Uncle Buster. We love the way you tell stories.
Hey, what's up?
Dude,
Grim, did you see Ben Roethlisberger's touchdown last night?
Oh, yeah. What, they're playing the Patriots?
No, dude, they're playing the Yankees.
The Yankees? You realize Ben Roethlisberger plays football, right?
No, that's Derek Jeter.
No. Derek Jr. plays baseball, Ben Roethlisberger plays football.
No, dude, Jackie Robinson plays for, like, the Pirates or something.
Jackie Robinson was the first black man to ever play baseball.
What are you watching, rugby or something?
No.
You need to get your sports straight, bro.
Hey, what's up?
Can't believe it, bro. My book report's due tomorrow, and I haven't even started reading the book.
What book?
A Tale of Two Cities.
By Charles Dickens?
I guess. Look at it.
Wow. It's really long. Pete, why'd you pick this one?
Well, you know, when I saw it on the list, I figured it's only two cities and not four. How long could it be?
Really long. Pete? It's really small. I don't think you can get this done in time.
Dude, I know. Like, what kind of book doesn't have pictures? Hey, Jared! Something's not right.
I can't believe it. She dumped me.
Julie dumped you?
Like a sack of wheat. She's going out with Isaiah tonight.
She's been going out with Isaiah for like a week.
Dude.
She has! A man is always the last to know.
Rough one.
And you know why? Because Isaiah has a car, and I don't! I begged my dad to lend me his car, but would he? No! Well, yeah, I no, maybe, possibly, yes, 95%, no, zero, yes, accurate. But how am I ever supposed to learn if he doesn't lend me his car?
Rough one.
Your parents
are weird.
My parents think I'm too young to drive.
Dude, that's so...
Dude, like, I'm wondering what she's gonna be doing tonight.
Oh, she's probably going cruising with him tonight. I don't want to go cruising, but you can't go cruising without a car. You look stupid.
Oh, I have an idea. There's a baseball game at Hackett tonight. Yes, Hackett. They're even worse than we are. You want to come?
Hold up. Isn't the game at Hackett?
Yeah, I'm taking the bus.
Number 85, finally. All right.
right. Now, how many friends did you say we're expecting?
A couple. Two.
All right. Thank you. That's right. Inside or patio?
The patio would be great.
Smoking or non-smoking?
Smoking? What do I look like?
Smoking or non-smoking?
Non-smoking.
Right. Sunny or shaded?
I don't know.
Please choose.
Shaded.
Hat or no hat?
Hat. Wait, what?
Hat or no hat?
It doesn't matter, hat or no hat. That's ridiculous.
Please choose.
Okay, fine. Hat.
All right. Hat. Congratulations. All right. You cannot have the hat section. You don't have a hat.
Then why do you ask? You could have just said...
Looks like we don't have a table ready now. Wait or no wait?
I'll wait. Could I have a glass of water while I wait? I'm really thirsty.
Of course. Ice or no ice?
Ice.
Foreign or domestic?
Just plain water is great.
Oh, right. Plain water that's foreign or plain water that's domestic?
Domestic is fine.
All right. Mountainous or lowland source?
Are you serious?
I am a hostess. We don't have time to kid around. Mountainous
or... Just get it out of town. That'd be great. Water out of town. So simple. What could be simpler?
Lemon or no lemon?
Whatever's quicker.
Please choose.
No lemon, plain, out of tap, forget the ice. Come on, please! Just have a simple glass of water!
Of course! There was no need to yell!
Excuse me.
Honestly, some people!
Irma Ho, named after my grandmother from North Dakota. I know my name doesn't sound cool, but at least I'm grateful I wasn't named after my other grandmother, Ida. I would have been Idaho. All the other girls in my class have really cool names that end in E. Katie, Sherry, Julie, Lindy, names that even sound cool if you shorten them. Kate, Cher, Jewel, Lynn, but if you shorten Irma, it's Irm. That rhymes with germ, squirm, and worm. There's no way to make a decent poem or love song out of that. When I turn 18, I'm changing my name to something that suits me, something with character. Desiree Amour, or Tiffany Chantilly, or something. Hey, you know, I could just change my name right now and tell people to start calling me that. And by the time it's legal, it'll be ipso facto. Maybe I should change my personality too. No 14-year-old should be using words like ipso facto. I read way too much. I'm going to the library to get some books on names. I just hope Ralph isn't there. He has such a crush on me. Like I would be seen with a guy named Ralph. So thanks, everybody.
You may know them by their brand names.
Equal, NutraSweet, Sweet and Low, Sweet Twin, Sweet One, Sonnet, and Splenda.
They even sound delicious. I use them to play with sugar, honey, and fruit.
Don't let fruit fool you. Did you know fruit has fructose, which, you guessed it, is sugar?
Put a couple tablespoons in water and your kids will never ask for milk again. Personally, I get rid of bowl for dessert.
Artificial sweeteners. No calories, no calories, no hyperactivity from sugar.
Artificial sweeteners, because they're naturally artificial.
That's Tick!
Woo. My kid's right out of an apple.
Is that the kid that keeps you up all night? Probably not. So that the audience can see the sign. There you go. I'm Logan. I know why, because I love you people too. I really do. But let's welcome our first family today on Lifestyle Feud. Our first family is living the new age lifestyle. Come on out, new age family! Well, I'm not sure which is the mother and which is the daughter.
Age is immaterial as long as you nourish the soul.
Which probably means you're the mother. Hello, Solstice, and this is little Lotus Loop.
I want a hot dog. But honey, where are we going?
Mom, sometimes all I want is a stupid hot dog once in a while.
They're made out of pig's lips. Never. Anything that can kiss you back.
I can do what I want.
And this is the little brother. Bummer, right?
Yo.
What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up?
Shut up!
Hello, Bummer, and what's up with you?
Slow your roll, bruh.
Whatever that means, let's welcome our second family today on Lifestyle Here. Bring them out, Bepida. Bepida. To Bepida! Here they are, the Overachievers. Overachievers, please introduce yourself.
My name is Huntington.
Hunt, welcome.
Hunt. Not Hunt, bruh. Huntington.
All right. Well, I'm not sure which is the mother and which is the daughter.
I'm his capable wife, Blair. Please don't waste your time being cutesy, stupid, and shallow.
She doesn't want me to waste time. Can I call you Blah for short?
Blah. Okay.
It was just a joke.
I don't have time for jokes, okay? I'm a busy woman. I'm a CEO of a medical.
And this cute child is?
Hi, I'm Vanessa. Vanessa Tiffany Brown. My dad promised me a Jeep when I turned 16. I have a little poodle named Stripes and a living kitty cat named Mappos. And when I grow up, I want to be best doctor.
Slow your roll, Juliet.
I don't know, Daddy, but I really doubt it. Honey, we're on national television trying to win lots of money. So I suggest you get with the program. We all have to.
And this cute child is?
I'm Brittany. I don't like being called cute. I'm a straight A student, I play lacrosse, and am active in the student government. It is inappropriate to call me cute.
You go, girl.
It is inappropriate to call me girl. Fine, you go, dweeb.
Anyway, let's welcome our third and final family fan lifestyle team, the Hunts. Bepida, bring out the Hunt. Bepida, the Hunt. Two words, Bepida. Infomercial.
Hey,
anymore. There you go. Hunts, please introduce yourselves.
Attila.
Attila the Hun.
Hog's not the mother.
Hog's not the mother, Hun.
Flathead.
Flathead.
Killer.
Killer.
Big neck.
And Big neck. Welcome, Hunts. It's nice to see a family that isn't too overly civilized now, isn't it?
What? A security guard?
Guess what the survey says. Ready? First question. Name the most popular thing an American family puts on a sandwich. You have 5 seconds. And go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time up. Huntington, what is your answer?
You came out with a family decision. Brittany, please tell them your answer.
The answer is Bob the Growler with Greg Paul.
Bad awesome. Bad work, no, no!
I said poopa! And get up here, bud.
Or a higher motor of food.
Anyway, Bob the Growler with Greg Poupon was... Solstice Mewclan, what is your answer?
We're torn. This is really hard.
I understood there were no trick questions on the ship.
We'll just give both answers. There's no absolutes. Fermented miso or germinated tofu mash.
Whatever that answer was, it was incorrect. Hunt, do you have an answer?
Warthog fat.
Warthog fat?
Warthog fat. Warthog fat. Warthog fat.
And the survey says? Baloney. Sorry, Hunt. On to the next round. Question 2. Are you ready? On a family picnic, what is the most popular activity? You have 10 seconds. And go!
5, 6, 7, 8, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Never mind, time's up! Overachievers, what is your answer?
Comparing optional equipment on the beamer.
That's the name of my band.
Bummer and the Beamer!
A beamer is a car. He's like one burger short of a happy meal.
I'd kill for a happy meal right now.
Bruh, never eat a meal that has emotion.
We already went over this. I can eat what I want.
Dead meat! It was once alive and now it's dead! So how can it be happy? It's all just a fake!
powerful ways while becoming one with the universe.
That's incorrect. Anybody else? Hunt! You have any?
Head tossing.
What's wrong, Hunts?
We have no hat.
It's just an expression. Nobody has hats.
She has hat.
What?
No, that's just Blair's hair.
We want hats. We want hats. We want hats.
And the third question is, on a European family vacation,
name
the most popular activity of an American tourist. You have 5 seconds. Ready? Go! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Overachievers, what is your answer?
Visiting great art museums.
Solstice Mewclam, what is your answer?
Searching for homes where our past lives were laid.
Hunt?
Pillage and plunder.
Pillage and plunder?